हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज मेथड्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट ऑफ प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड। एंड वी नो दैट द इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज डिफरेंट फॉर डिफरेंट गुड्स। द मेजरमेंट ऑफ प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड कैन बी लुक्ड एट फ्रॉम टू व्यू पॉइंट। नंबर वन इज पॉइंट इलास्टिसिटी, point elasticity and arc elasticity. Now we have to understand what is point elasticity. So point elasticity means when the elasticity of demand is measured at a particular point on the demand curve, then it is called point elasticity. We can explain this concept with the help of a diagram also. Suppose this is our demand curve. Now, on this demand curve, when we are measuring the value of elasticity at a point R, then this concept is called point elasticity. Now, next one we have arc elasticity. So, arc elasticity means when we measure the elasticity of demand between finite range or between two points. Suppose say we have two point R and R1. So when we are measuring the value of elasticity between these two range R and R1, then this concept is called arc elasticity of demand. Now next, point elasticity, the method used for measuring the point elasticity is called point method. This one is called point method or geometric method. And the method used for measuring or the arc elasticity of demand can be measured by two methods. Number one, we have percentage method, and number two, we have total expenditure method. Once again, the method used for measuring the point elasticity is called point method or geometric method. And the method used for measuring the arc elasticity is percentage method or total expenditure method. So these two methods can be used to measure this arc elasticity. And in order to measure the point elasticity, we can use this point method or geometric method. So here we have three important methods to measure the price elasticity of demand. Number one, we have percentage method. Number two, we have total expenditure. And number three, we have point method or we have point method or geometric method. Now we explain one by one what is percentage method, what is total expenditure method, and point method or geometric method. The first method we have percentage method. So what is percentage method? Percentage method means it is the ratio of percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. That is EP equals to ratio of percentage change in quantity demand divided by percentage change in price. So this derivation we have already done while doing the definition of price elasticity of demand, and we have got the formula EP equals to del Q by del P into P by Q. So this is the method of percentage. So this portion we have already completed. So I am not going to explain you the same topic again and again. I will move it to the next method, that is total expenditure method. One of the method suggested by Alfred Marshall to measure the elasticity of demand is total expenditure method. So in the case of total expenditure method, the elasticity of demand is measured by changes in total expenditure due to change in the prices of a commodity. So when the price of a commodity, when price changes, your total expenditure will also change. So depending on the situation, we can see that the demand will be elastic, inelastic or immediately elastic, just looking at the expenses or total expenses. According to total expenditure method, the elasticity of demand can be measured by considering the changes in total expenditure due to change in the price of a commodity. So when we compare the changes in the total expenditure before and after the changes in the price, then we will be able to know the price elasticity of demand for different goods, whether the demand will be elastic, inelastic or unitary elastic. By using this total expenditure method, we can be able to measure only three categories of elasticities. Number one, unitary elastic. Number two, elastic. And number three, inelastic. So depending on the total expenditure, when we compare the total expenditure before changing the price and after changing the price, then we'll be able to know whether the demand is unitary elastic or inelastic in the case of total expenditure method. Now next, what is unitary elastic? So in the case of unitary elastic, when the total expenditure of commodity does not change due to change in the price of commodity, then elasticity is known as unitary elastic. For example, consider the price of commodity suppose 60, and when the price of commodity is 60, suppose quantity demand is 10 units. So total expenditure TE, total expenditure equals to price into quantity. Now when we multiply this price and quantity, so 60 into 10 equals to 600. So here the total expenditure is 600. Now if the price of commodity falls from 60 to suppose say 50, and due to fall in price of commodity from 60 to 50, if quantity demanded increases from suppose say 10 to 12, in this case the total expenditure will be 50 into 12 is equals to 600. So here before the change in price, the total expenditure is 600. After the change in price from 60 to 50, we can see that the quantity demand is increasing from 10 to 12, and here also the total expenditure is 600. So in this case, the total expenditure does not change due to change in price of commodity. So in this case, we get EP is equals to 1, or the price elasticity of demand will be equals to 1. Here, the total expenditure is remaining same. Next, we have elastic demand. So when the fall in price of commodity results in an increase in total expenditure, once again listen, in the case of elastic demand, when a fall in price of a commodity leads to increase in total expenditure, then the elasticity of demand will be greater than EP, will be greater than 1. This can be also explained with the help of one example. Let's consider we have price, quantity and total expenditure. Total expenditure. So suppose if price of commodity is 60, and when price of commodity is 60, suppose a consumer is purchasing 10 units. So here total expenditure will be P into Q. So price into quantity, price 60 into units 10. So here we'll get 600. Now if price falls from 60 to 50, now due to that, if quantity demand increases from 10 to suppose 30 units, so here total expenditure will be 50 into 30, so we will get 650. So if you compute the total expenditure due to fall in price of commodity, the total expenditure is increasing from 600 to 650. In this case, we will get EP greater than 1. That means here the value of elasticity of demand will be greater than 1. So this is the case of elastic demand. The last one we have, inelastic demand. So when a fall in price of commodity reduces the total expenditure, once again listen, when a fall in price of commodity reduces the total expenditure, then the value of elasticity of demand will be less than EP, will be less than 1. This can be also explained with the help of one example. Let us consider price, quantity and total expenditure. Total expenditure. So here we have, suppose the price is 60 rupees. When price is 60, suppose quantity demand is 10 units. And the total expenditure will be P into Q. That means 60 into 10. We'll have this 600. Next, if the price falls from 60 to suppose 50 rupees, and due to that, suppose quantity demand is increasing from 10 to 11 units, then if you calculate the total expenditure, will get 50 into 11 equals to 550. So here we can see that due to fall in price of commodity from 60 to 50, the total expenditure of commodity is decreasing from 600 to 550. So your total expenditure is decreasing from 600 to 550. So in this case, the EP will be less than 1. Here, the value of price elasticity of demand will be less than 1. So this is the case of inelastic demand in total expenditure method.